This is an incredible experience. This is the second time that Centre College has had a vice presidential debate. It's a time for the community to come together with the college. It's the time for the college to meet the world and the world to meet Centre College. It's incredible.
The atmosphere is electric here. You can taste it in the air. It's incredible. The eyes of the world are on Centre College, and it's an amazing feeling.
The world has come to Danville today. Very exciting.
Centre is a place that knows how to do things and do things the right way. We've been anticipating this for almost a year now. We found out last Halloween that we'd be hosting it. And at that time, President Roush gave out bags that were made up and said, it's in the bag.
Fast forward nearly 1 year, and the stage is literally being set. But the real stars of this production, the faculty, staff, and above all the students, had long ago taken center stage.
For an event like the vice presidential debate, it has a chance to be a lot more impactful at a school like Center because we're so small and because students are so involved in volunteering with everything that goes on here.
They meet the candidates coming in, they're in the motorcade, they shake their hands, they're going to see the debate. I mean, how much better can it get?
The other day, one of my students had a press pass, you know, these very sophisticated, I can't even get a press pass. You know, they're getting in places that I don't have permission to go. So we really try to give students the priority. And again, it's their campus, it's their experience.
The academic experience had already been enhanced as issues were viewed through the lens of the upcoming debate.
Questions of ethics and the separation of church and state and applying morals to foreign policy and domestic policy have been brought up. And it's amazing because the education I'm receiving here has become so applicable to so many parts of my life that I never expected.
We understand that a liberal arts education is not divorced from the world. Learning for learning's sake isn't something that means you have no connection to the world. In fact, learning for learning's sake prepares you to be part of the world.
It's gotten a little bit amped up here lately. We've got barriers everywhere and fences and helicopters flying overhead. It's definitely taken our quiet little Danville, Kentucky campus and turned it around a little bit.
Newland Hall was off limits, unless you happen to be a student usher or one of the students selected to stand in for the candidates and debate moderator.
This is just an incredible experience, and I'm very honored that I was chosen for it, and I hope that I can represent the college at the highest level.
In Spin Alley, it was lights, cameras, with the action less than 24 hours away. Inside the Media Filing Center, journalists from around the world began taking their positions and interviewing our own center faculty experts.
I got to do something wonderful just a couple of hours ago, participate in an hour-long panel discussion that was broadcast on NPR and recorded right here on campus. I was sitting 3 feet away from Don Gagne, who's one of the chief political reporters for NPR. That was a thrill, and so that was exciting to be able to be involved in that.
Michael Sackett.
And on the steps of Young Hall, 100 lucky students learned that they would get to attend the big event.
And when they read that first name and that, whoa, it was absolutely incredible.
Jocelyn Cantor.
Actually, I was in the locker room with the soccer team and our coach had just finished speaking and I checked my phone and I started screaming and jumping up and down in the locker room because I had several text messages from my friends telling me I had gotten a ticket.
That night, the lobby of the Norton Center was transformed as members of the media got a true taste of Kentucky.
Centre College, you know, is in a class of its own. It has been a fantastic private school in our state for years and years and years, and they did a great show in year 2000. They're going to do even a better show here in 2012, and I'm looking forward to it.
President Roush had ordered a perfect Kentucky autumn day, and so it was. As crowds gathered around the MSNBC stage, it was easy to find people bearing uniquely center messages.
Dead Fred's a big part of the campus tradition here. We thought he likes going to ball games, he might want to come and see all this too.
Some students carried their message right on their bodies.
I'm one of the 85% of Center students who have gone abroad. That's something we really value at Center. We like to send people all over the world.
We didn't farm it out to some tourist company to take us around. It was me on the ground with them, going through all the places in Beijing that I had lived in. It's those sorts of things that probably make the biggest and most lasting impression on the students. Is the professors are right there in the thick of it with them.
I can't even imagine anything better. I love my school so much, and this just adds to it.
Other center messages were a bit hopeful. The wish, for example, that political candidates would conduct themselves civilly, something our students have pledged to do.
Students have lots of different opinions on things. They have to voice those opinions in a way that they're civil and they're able to interact with each other in a positive way. And there's something about a debate that I think is very similar to that and that students can relate to.
Starting in the early afternoon, Old Center Lawn was the perfect place to be for the huge debate festival. Center's own musicians, Center alumni, and a variety of other groups put on a never-ending concert for an ever-growing audience.
They were all right there in front of the stage, cheering me on, knew the words to our original songs.
Yeah.
And just to see the campus like this, it looks beautiful. I'm just very proud to be a Center alum, so it was an awesome experience.
Students, faculty, Danville residents sitting side by side with alumni who returned to campus just for this event.
I would want those alumni to just see, even though campus has changed, the spirit of Center College hasn't, and we're still doing great things, and we're still shooting for the moon, if you will, for what Center can achieve.
And as the clock ticked down to the start of the debate, there were still hundreds of Center volunteers hard at work.
We have about 50 students who are covering the vice presidential debate live as they experience it, whether they're out in on the festival lawn or whether they're here in the media center like I am. And most of us, at least, are wearing our Team Twitter t-shirts, and they have the hashtag on the back.
I'm running on about 4 hours of sleep, and I've been up since 5:30, and it's worth every minute of it.
I've actually been up in the Obama for America headquarters the whole time, and that's where I'll be spending the rest of the evening, too.
This college has afforded me so, so much, and I don't think I could ever explain how grateful I am to have been a Center Colonel for these 4 years.
At the core of the college's mission is to change lives. That is something that President Roush emphasizes and that our professors emphasize. Coming into Center from a rural county high school in Kentucky, where I had very little to no knowledge of how to even cite a paper. Coming to Center College and learning how to do that, how to organize my ideas and communicate them effectively, the experiences in and out of the classroom have radically changed the way that I look at life. And I can thank Center College for that.
We're experiencing history, and I'm so happy to be here. I picked the best school in the country.